Hey everybody, welcome back to Module 3, Welch's Math Class. We are here doing a little bit of simplifying fractions. To simplify a fraction, what we're going to be doing is looking for numbers that will divide evenly into both the numerator, that is the top, and the denominator, that is the bottom, of a fraction. We'll be looking for any number that will divide evenly into the top and also to the bottom. The number that we divide out must divide out of the top and must divide out of the bottom. There are some particular look-fors when we do this. If we see zeros on the end of the top and the bottom, we can automatically cancel those zeros. It's like dividing by 10 on the top and bottom, or 100 if there's two zeros. So that's one thing we want to look for right away. If the top and bottom end in 5 or 0, or one ends in 5 and the other one ends in 0, we can divide the top and the bottom both by 5. If the top and the bottom of the fraction are both even numbers, let's say one ends in a 2 and the other one ends in a 6, we know we can divide both of those by 2. And so we've got these simple little look-fors that will move us pretty quickly through simplifying most fractions. Let's do a couple of examples here. Suppose we want to simplify 90 over 110. Well, the first thing we're going to notice is simply that they both end in 0, so let's cancel the zeros and knock this straight down to 9 over 11. Now, when we canceled those zeros, it was the same as if we had divided the top by 10 and divided the bottom by 10. We just did it by canceling those zeros. Of course, when we get to 30 over 90, we can do the same thing and we'll get 3 over 9. Now, at this point with 3 over 9, we should notice that there's more we can do. We can still divide more out of this. A 3 will actually go into 3, and 3 will also go into 9. And so when we divide this by 3 and divide the bottom by 3, what we'll end up with is 1/3. So 30 over 90 then ends up being 1/3. Okay, let's take a quick look at this last one, a little more difficult. 700 over 910. Okay, so my first order of business is to notice the zeros on the end, this zero with this zero, and knock this right on down to 70 over 91. Now, I'm looking for something that'll go into 70 that'll also go into 91. That's a challenge. I think I'm gonna go through my look-fors. I've already done the zeros on the end. One of these numbers still ends in a 0, but the other one does not end in a 5, so I can't use 5. This one's even, but this one's not. So at this stage, what I might think about is going through my list of primes. I might try thinking about dividing both of them by 3, just using my calculator, dividing by 3. You'll quickly see that wouldn't work. So we know 2 doesn't work. We know 3 doesn't work. By the way, if 2 won't go in, no other even number will either. So we can forget about 4 or 6 or 8 or any other even number, because the 2 would not work on the 91. No even number will work on 91. Okay, so 2 won't work, 3 won't work, 4 won't work, 5 won't work, 6 won't work, 7. I think we'll see if we divide both these numbers by 7, checking on our calculator. And we have to divide them both by 7. It can't just be one or the other. Both of them have to be divisible by 7. What we'll see is we'll end up with 10, and 91 divided by 7, I believe, is 13. And so our final simplification for 700 over 910 is 10 over 13. And so, again, with simplifying fractions, we're just looking for what might come out of the top that'll also come out of the bottom, and we just chop these down little by little. And it might take going through a couple of times before we get down to the simplest form, but that's the best way, the simplest way, actually, to simplify. Is to just break it down little by little. All right, I want you to jump back into your practice. I want you to practice simplifying some fractions, and I will see you next time.